And what's great is that if you keep reading in Luke, in that same chapter, Luke chapter 24, is that eventually everybody ends up in the same place. They all started in very different places. The women had this very direct personal encounter. Some of the men doubted. Some of them had to go see for themselves. But at the end of it, Jesus actually comes and, like you said, reveals himself to them. They believe. Their faith is restored. And they all end up in the same place of grace. And then the most important part is that they're sent out. Once Jesus has revealed himself and their faith is again restored, he then sends them out and says, okay, now you go into all the world and spread the good news. They move from a place of fear to a place of faith, and then they're sent out and commissioned. And I think for every single one of us, that's the same story that we get to enter into and continue on with today. As we move from a place of fear to a place of faith, when we encounter the good news, we are then commissioned to go and share that and to spread it and to make it known. And so for every single one of us, wherever you find yourself in this story, there's an invitation. We have an opportunity to meet Jesus today. We have an opportunity to encounter this very same good news. We each have a choice that we get to make. And it's going to, just like the way that disciples encountered Jesus, it looked a little different for each of them. The invitation and opportunity will likely look a little different for each one of us too. And so, will you talk a little bit about this choice, this opportunity and invitation that we find in front of us, and just some of the different ways that we might respond to that?
Well, I think you've already implied that, in that as those first followers of Jesus, the first ones to trust in Jesus, they come to a place of faith and then they're sent out. Well, we're the same way. You know, that's what faith does, is it unfreezes us so that we can move somewhere. So we have choices. Before, they're very self-oriented, you know, just afraid and hiding. I don't want anybody to know that they're here. But the fact that something happened in their lives and they're telling the story is actually why we're here and telling that story, you know. And the same thing happens to us. And so I think there's some opportunities here for us to meet Jesus in some new ways, to receive the good news in either a renewed way or a deeper way, a way that we move from fear of risk to greater trust, based on whatever is important to me. I mean, Mary hears Jesus call her own name, and she's like, oh man, I know who that is. And maybe that's you. And maybe you're like the disciples, that you're like, I don't know, it sounds pretty sketchy, you know. Or somebody who's like, I'm going to look into this more. We would just kind of want to invite you to take that step, whatever that looks like to you. That what Easter means is there is good news out there that you can trust. Just like we're out here, there's plenty of good news in the world. There's a lot of people fighting this virus. There's a lot of people doing great things. There's good news out there. And what happens is I begin to receive that. I move from my self-orientation to including, involving others. I can begin to live with an open hand with the things that I have, and not be so afraid, and I can invite other people in. And what happens is I actually become good news. And I think part of what we want to say here is that what the resurrection of Jesus says ultimately is that God loves you. That our greatest crisis is something that God is deeply involved with. And even though we may have been in places where we've experienced death, or we've given up, or we've had failures, that the resurrection of Christ says there's good news. And even in those dead places, in those places of pain, God can bring life. So I want you to think right now, just on the thought, maybe say to yourself, God loves me. I want you to hear that. I want you to sense that, and have a sense that God loves you. There is good out there. And when I know that I'm loved, guess what? Now I can have hope, you know? When I'm isolated and I'm afraid, I'm afraid to do anything. But when I realize that somebody loves me, maybe I can have some hope where I had no hope before.